kraju pozvao bih doktora Mladena Janjića da prenese naše iskustva u laparoskopskoj kolorektalnoj hirurgiji.
Poštovane koleginice i kolege, nadam se da se u ovako velikom broju ostali, barem delom i zbog mog predavanja, a uglavnom većinom zbog diskusije koja će biti i koja će verovatno biti veoma interesantna svima. Cilj ove prezentacije je da prikažemo naša početna iskustva u primjeni modularnog tipa treninga u laparoskopskoj kolorektalnoj hirurgiji pod rukovodstvom profesora Amjada Parvajza. Trenutna situacija, kao što svi dobro znamo u Srbiji, da pacijenti sve više traže da budu laparoskopski operisani, zato što informacije mogu lako da se nađu pre svega na internetu i svi sad to gledaju i čitaju, pa onda traže laparoskopsku operaciju. Hirurzi, mladi u velikoj većini, ali i mi stariji, sve češće i sve glasnije tražimo da dobijemo odgovarajuću opremu i da dobijemo odgovarajući trening i obuku da bi mogli da radimo laparoskopsku hirurgiju. I na kraju ovo treće, ne bi baš previše komentarisao, ali reći ću samo da mi nemamo nacionalni program, o čemu je profesor Amjad u njegovom prvom predavanju prilično detaljno govorio. Najbolja ilustracija za ovu situaciju u Srbiji je upravo hronologija razvoja laparoskopske kolorektalne hirurgije kod nas u našoj bolnici. Mi smo prvi put glasno, jasno i vrlo energično tražili da dobijemo novi napredni stup za laparoskopsku naprednu hirurgiju na trećem našem workshopu, kada je Richard Cohen bio naš gost i profesor Carkov 2008. godine. Pa smo 2011. na četvrtom workshopu uradili prvu laparoskopsku kolorektalnu operaciju. Tada je profesor Maher Abbas iz Kalifornije to uradio na pozajemljenom stupu. 2013. kao što sam na samom početku kad sam predstavljao naše goste, imali prvi put priliku da radimo sa profesorom Amjadom. On je prihvatio tada naš poziv da dođe i uradili smo dve laparoskopske operacije zajedno, ali ponovno na pozemljenom stupu. To nas je naterao da osnovimo udruženje građana Krug zdravlja i da pokrenemo široku akciju, ne bi li na kraju dobili takav odgovarajući laparoskopski stup da možemo da krenemo u dalju obuku. I profesor Amjad i ja smo se na takozvanom našem prokletijskom dogovoru napravili jedan deal da neće biti ovog šestog workshopa ako dotle ne dobijemo opremu i ne započnemo trening. I na sreću, to smo uspeli, u junu mesecu ove godine profesor je ponovo bio kod nas, uradili smo 4 operacije u 2 dana, ovog puta na našem stupu. U septembru mesecu ove godine uradili smo prvu operaciju samostalno, naravno uz pomoć doktora Jordana Lazarevića iz Valjeva. Svi znamo da on od 2003. godine radi laparoskopske operacije debelog creva i da ima jednu od najvećih serija u našoj zemlji. Ovo je naš prvi pacijent kojeg smo uradili. Profesor je govorio o modularnom treningu i ja ne bi sad tu mnogo ponavljao o tom konceptu i ovde vidimo rad koji je on objavio 2011. godine u Journal of Surgery, da bi ilustrovali naša iskustva u ovoj vrsti treninga. Mi ćemo se fokusirati zbog kratkoće vremena samo na modus 5 i 6. To je submodul u okviru modula 1, a to je izolacija i presecanje krvnih sudova i disekcija od medijalnog ka lateralnog, zbog kratkoće vremena. Ja ću pustiti 4 kratka videoklipa gde ćete videti kako je išla ta evolucija od prvog gde se vidi kako profesor operiše sa njegovim kamermanom i veoma detaljno nam objašnjava onako kako bi svaki profesor trebao da objašnjava svojim učenicima svaki korak i svaki postupak, svaki detalj hiruške tehnike prilikom rada i svi koji budete sutra na workshopu uverit ćete se kako to izgleda. Druga operacija je kada mu ja držim kameru, to je već malo onako polako idemo na dole, Treća operacija, ja operišem, profesor Amđad drži kameru, to njega onako, mislim, nije to baš lako, ja mu se divim kako može, pogotovo s nama starijim hirurzima, i sve vreme rukovodi i daje instrukcije. I na kraju ćete vidjeti najkraći klip, tako smo Jordan i ja uradili naš prvi rektum.
This is an important step of the operation because the air goes like this and air tracks along the vessels. So the bottom half of this air, if I burn here, this would take me to the right iliac artery. Yeah?
Yes.
So I always go at the top end of the air, not the bottom end. Some people don't sort of see this as a potential problem, but this can be a potential problem, see? So maybe this is the beginning of the IMA. I hook towards me rather than healing it because I am at the pelvic brim. In thin people, it's very easy actually to cause the damage. I only paint when I come to the side or when I'm too sure what I'm painting on. See, what I'm sort of, with my one eye is looking for constantly is the back of inferior mesenteric artery. If it doesn't look familiar to you, then you have to make it look familiar. And the plane really is at the back of the IMA. So if my assistant comes from the side and do a tilt, then we both would see where we are in relation to our main artery. See the air? Air is okay.
Angel hair.
Angel hair, yeah. These hairs exist everywhere actually. Even the common people have this rather than angels. Sacral promontory, angel hairs, right pelvic nerve, left pelvic nerve is here. Now I concentrate on taking the artery. That in slim patients, you are right above the iliac vein. See this?
Yes.
You know, you burn this without seeing it, and then the whole operation becomes a bit different. So here now, the embryological layers would move in the right direction. And if you notice one thing, when I put my left hand in, I don't move my left hand. That becomes a static traction. But most important structure is the fascia that cover the ureter, you know, the embryological fascias.
Yes.
So if you keep that intact, then the ureter would be behind that automatically. So that's why I'm more interested in not to burn anything retroperitoneum and just use this pushing device to do this. The ureter would just appear and I show you when it does it. There. So if you are seeing this, the ureter would be down here.
Yes.
Yeah? So I'm, yeah, exactly. But I'm not interested here. I'm interested here because that's where the layers are. And the true sort of true glimpse is that if we end up seeing our psoas muscle very clean, then we are one layer too far back. He's a slim chap, which is great, but also in slim chap, it's very easy to make mistake. As you know, as a surgeon, we're never happy. Either they are too fat or they're too thin. All bites, see, not bigger than this, not like this. Just there, just the tip of the instrument. You need to really see the artery and then stick to the artery. Next step now is to move Mladen a bit further down on the IMA because you see it progress from there. See where it started here.
Yes.
Now we come back. That's an important step to keep telling yourself as a surgeon and assistant to have the right traction on the vessel. My boss used to say all bleeding stop eventually. Now watch this. This is the left hand which is holding it, which has created the window. And I just do this side to side movement. There is no forcing your instrument through. The left hand should have the IMV in this package. This is my window and you see how I make my window there. The back is the key, not to push it in too far in. And this is the time to talk to your God. You know, if you believe in God, this is the time to talk to Him. Because you don't want problem at this level, like this. So God is on our side today. This is a true embryological operation. If you can just sort of demonstrate this. So we go here. And he's very, very thin, you know. That's the ureter's layer. See the fascia here? The white line just at the tip. You see that? It's there. It's there in every patient. You just need to see it and demonstrate it. I always say this is not a punishment. You know, you need to enjoy this operation. And I can keep pushing it here, doesn't matter. You need to go and hit it on the head. Just there, then it moves. You see, it's very interesting. The way it is stretched. You know, I can stretch the vein and make it look very thin.
Yes.
One for me, one for patient, and one for the lawyer. Have enough space to have a gap, then I take the tension off the vessel. Because if you're pulling on it and burning with harmonic, it will ping. sometimes. You just take the tension off.
Mislim da ste u ovih 4 minuta mogli da steknete utisak kako to izgleda 4 sata biti u operacionoj sali sa takvim profesorom i moram da vam kažem da sam ja skoro 20 godina lutao po celom svetu i da sam na kraju u svojoj 55. godini našao profesora kako ja zamišljam da bi on trebao da bude.
Ashton Schimmelberg been just there.
Ovo ja držim kameru.
So if you come back now, there's some adhesions which are not supposed to be here. See this? This adhesion come closer. Yet Yannick is very young, you know, he can see it from very far. I can't. I have to be really close. That's the distance. And that's the study. Just like a BBC cameraman. Not like American cameraman. So that's the way. It's a Wade is a very important landmark for left-sided reception because Wade often gives you a clue where the true embryology is. Now, Wade is a fixed landmark. Artery could be variable because sometimes they have a very good loop, sometimes they have a very short loop, so the artery could be, but Wade is always going to be DJ flexure. So whenever you are in doubt, you should go and look for the Wade. Okay? So right iliac and the right ureter will be here. Yeah. Start at this level, at the sacral pulmonary level, right? So what you do is you make a start and you go behind the peritoneum and you wait for the air. Come closer, I'm looking for this air. And just stabilize your hand for a few seconds and let it go. Honestly, yes, I promise you. There, that's the white line there. That's the white line of tall fascia there, starting. Yannick, come in to the camera. Thank you. This is the white line. See, everybody would see it. Just there. It's all about exposure. You know, it's all about seeing. You see, but I'm spending most of the time to expose better so I can see better. You can come closer. This is the back of the superior rectal artery. The important thing is with using hook, don't use hook like this, you know, because you don't know what you're burning at the back. If you notice, I use the hook, I just use the front one third. So I can see it all the time, but I'm pulling towards. Okay, good. Okay, with me, that's the job of the right. This is the front of the fag of the IMA. IMA is there. Because we are worried that the artery is there and it might bleed, we go away from it. The more you go away from it, the more it bleeds. So you really have to come right onto the artery. It's like in life, sometimes you just have to face your fear. How are you? You are doing very well, you know. It was 2 years ago.
Yes.
We lost our
yes.
So from that point of view, you're doing better than me. I have to join this air to this air. These are the nerves that have been pulled up. That's where the window is going to be. It's a bit too thick because you can see there's good at the back here.
God of surgery.
You're a very good learner. My trainees, I teach them in a language which hopefully most of the married men understand. I always say, Wade is like a wife in the house. You have to treat it with a lot of respect, love and care, because you really don't want to upset it. Because when the Wade bleeds, it's disaster. And man is like an artery, you know, it looks very difficult, but it all it takes is one clip to sort it. Yeah? No? Made it there. You can see the bit open. Open this so you can divide the top of the peritoneum just like this. Pinch. See, close your instrument now, close. And then what I do is I turn on the way. Watch this movement. 1, 2, there's your way.
Just 2.
There you go. So you go clip please. Right? Happy?
Yes.
Now take a mic. So one for the patient, one for the lawyer. One for the surgeon. Slow down, very slow down. I know everybody is watching and it's difficult to slow down. Open jaws. Okay. Good. Excellent.
Ovaj treći nije još gotovo. Jeste da je kraj dana i poslednje predavanje. Ima još dva, vrlo kratka. Ovaj treći Yao
Pe. Keep open. So you got to keep him honest, yeah? Your hook is too far deep. You notice that today I was using this. You're playing this camera?
No, no.
This is a big saw. This is the back of the artery here.
Oh, here.
Okay. Is there?
te godine, kad smo 2013. završili workshop, razmišljali smo dugo kako da se zahvalimo i odužimo profesoru, pa smo smislili da mu uvedemo modularni trening planinarenja i taj kurs smo započeli na prokletijama. Isto kao i u hirurgiji, u samom početku je najteže odrediti pravi put, odnosno pravi embriološki sloj. Međutim, profesor je rođen ispod Himalaja i njemu očigledno u genima se nalazi da vrlo lako nalazi pravi embriološki sloj. I kad ste u pravom sloju, sve postaje kristalno jasno. Kao i u hirurgiji. Pošto je on brzo uči, kao što je on meni dao kompliment da brzo uči, tako i on brzo uči planinarenju i ja verujem da će za jedno dve godine da bude odličan planinar. Ovde smo kompletirali submodula našeg modularnog treninga planinarenja, a vi vidite u pozadini se vidi submodul D, nisam samo siguran da ćemo baš do njega da dođemo. I ovo je ekipa koja je zadužena za profesorovu obuku. I u zaključku bih želeo da kažem da su naši planovi i naša ambicija da nastavimo sa treningom, onako kako je profesor predložio, to bi bilo zaista najbolje i to je on jutros meni saopštio o tom njegovom nekom predlogu i planu i o tome ćemo sigurno razgovarati narednih nedelja i meseci. Ali ono što ćemo mi da završimo, a to je da ćemo da kompletiramo naš trening do sledećeg workshopa 2017. godine i tada ćemo moći da vam prikažemo i te naše rezultate. I ono što je za nas jako važno i što mi već radimo, da se povežemo sa svim timovima u Srbiji i da zajedno u operacionoj sali pre svega razmenjujemo iskustva. Jer i ovo dok smo radili u operacionoj sali je bio priličan broj hirurga koji su zainteresovani i mladih i starijih. I nikako ne bih želeo da ne spomenem naše, pre svega, najbliže saradnike sa kojima često imamo i manjih ili većih sukoba, to su anesteziolozi, ovo je naš tim koji zaista uloži ogroman napor, kao i instrumentarke i sestre na odelenju koji su podržale, pre svega, entuzijazam profesora Amđada, koji je prešao na nas, pa posle sa nas i na sve saradnike naše u Pančevačkoj bolnici. I na kraju, to je ekipa koloproktološkog odseka Pančevačke bolnice. Hvala vam na pažnju.